or on with a South Luzon. Again, to all the PCCI South Luzon, let's have a photo op with the Vice President, Sara Z. Duterte.
Mga kababayan, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Madayaw ug maayong adlaw kaninyong tanan. Magandang araw sa inyong lahat. First off, let me thank the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry for your invitation for me to join you on this momentous occasion, 50 years of the PCCI. I am truly happy. This is my third year with PCCI. And I will tell you later kung bakit paboritong paborito ko umattend na PCCI event. But let me first give out my messages of gratitude. First, I'd like to thank all of you for your continued support to the Office of the Vice President, our projects, programs, and activities across the country. Daghang salamat sa inyong padayon nga suporta. My next message of gratitude is from our family, the Duterte family. Nagpapasalamat po kami sa patuloy ninyo na suporta at sa pagkakataon na ibinibigay ninyo sa amin na makapaglingkod sa ating bayan. Maraming salamat po, mga kababayan namin. And of course, let me thank and give special mention to the Davao City Chamber of Commerce and Industry. I cannot discount the tremendous help, support, and assistance that the Davao Chamber gave me during my terms as Mayor of Davao City. Kaya po ako, sila po ang nagturo sa akin na napakahalaga ng business sector, ng private sector, sa trabaho ng gobyerno. Maraming salamat sa inyo. Kaya naman, noong ako ay naging Vice President, dinala ko yung values na tinuro sa akin ng Davao City Chamber of Commerce na mahalaga ang Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry sa trabaho ko bilang Vice President. Because the government do not have the monopoly of brilliant minds. In fact, many geniuses are found in the private sector. That is why it is very important that there should be collaboration between the government and the private sector, the business sector. Kaya paborito ko na umattend talaga dito sa PCCI para din magpasalamat sa inyong lahat sa contribution ninyo sa ating bansa. I would like to congratulate all the awardees. Thank you for your service to our country. And I would like to congratulate the Secretariat and the Execom for the 50 years anniversary program. Congratulations on the success of your celebration. Let me congratulate the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry as you mark your 50th year of unparalleled advocacy for bringing economic security and stability to the nation. Through your leadership, members of the business sector finds a common platform of convergence where new business trends and opportunities are explored, adapted, and revolutionized. This year, as you embark on ways to address the challenges presented by new and emerging opportunities, I trust that you will successfully forge sustainable strategies that will empower the business community. We cannot deny the very crucial and important role of innovation in this age of digitalization. Digitalization has complemented our human resources in ensuring efficient operations and timely production, and of course, delivery of services and products. We cannot refuse the benefits of digitalization in our businesses. We should consider it a gift to humanity, a gift that we should accept with grateful hearts and be willing to invest in digital infrastructures. While we consider digitalization our friend, we cannot entirely say the same with innovation. Innovation has profoundly transformed the business environment and raised the competitiveness of every industry, here and overseas. The industry is always expected to adopt new technologies in producing products, and products are expected to be innovative, to be successful. By innovative, a product or service must offer something unique, something special, added value, if not better or superior to the ones already existing. Embracing new innovation is inevitable, or we will be left behind in the grind, as we are compared to our neighbors and compared to the rest of the world, where competition between and among humans becomes increasingly cutthroat. But innovations have also become inescapable markers for humans, allowing them to imagine a future dominated by technology. The coming of artificial intelligence, for one, is a cautionary tale for many of us, bringing the world anxiety, if not panic, from doomsayers presenting us a dystopian picture where AIs govern humans. It is both expected and understandable because we are, after all, beings who are almost always scared of things we do not know. Alam nyo, sa mga taon na nagtatrabaho ako sa gobyerno, innovation comes from people, and the challenges to innovation comes from three kinds of people. Una, yung mga masisira ang kanilang negosyo. Ayaw nila mag-innovate. Ayaw nila magbago. Kasi bakit? Masisira yung diskarte, yung negosyo namin dito sa gobyerno. Pangalawa, yung mga taong takot. Ay, hindi namin alam yan. Huwag yan. Mahihirapan tayo niyan. At pangatlo, yung mga tao na ayaw ng pagbabago. Yan ang tatlong klaseng tao ang nakita ko. Tao ang gagawa ng innovation, pero tao din ang kukontra sa innovation. But AI has also caused excitement and more people are drawn to the opportunity it offers. Ultimately, humans should ensure that AI becomes our partner in improving lives and making the world a safer place. We should replace the fear of the unknown with profound optimism by using technological advances such as AIs to achieve greater operational productivity. The government and the private sector can collaborate to create innovation centers and foster an environment that encourages risk-taking and experimentation. With the ingenuity and creativity of Filipinos, I believe we can do more to create better products and systems that will bring profit and move our industries forward. Alam niyo, I believe Filipinos can be the next, I forgot his name, the owner of Tesla. A Filipino can be the next Elon Musk. We are a powerhouse of geniuses. Hindi lang sa ating mga professionals, but yung mga nasa loob ng ating mga colleges and universities. We just need to do that dream. Now, we don't want to be middle income. We want to be a super power, and we can. It's just a matter of putting that vision in every Filipino mind. Let me cite examples of how Filipinos have demonstrated our capacity to excel using modern technology and creating innovative solutions to perennial problems. The Philippine robotics team, led by some of our science high school and private schools, has showcased exceptional talent and innovation on the global stage, competing against teams from different countries with more advanced robotics programs. They have secured major awards in prestigious competitions. With government and private sector support, imagine what our Filipino youth can do to create solutions for various challenges, from disaster relief to agricultural optimization. Filipinos can create products that disrupt the market by thinking outside the box and embracing new innovative technologies. In business, technological advances have optimized business operations. It continues to enhance the effectiveness of management with real-time data and faster communication. Employees, too, benefit from these innovations by simplifying tasks, automating repetitive work, and facilitating collaboration and transparency between management and employees. Because the technological revolution has also led to job displacement in certain sectors, we should consider the urgency of reskilling and upskilling our workers and equip them with the new skills in a technologically evolving workplace. By investing in workforce development, we can harness the power of technology to create a more effective and productive future while ensuring that employees are equipped to thrive in this new landscape. By inspiring more Filipino innovators, especially entrepreneurs and students, to innovate and think outside of the box, we can harness the power of innovation to foster inclusive growth and development, while ensuring that its benefits reach all Filipinos across all segments of society. Alam niyo po, noong ako ay kalihim ng kagawaran ng edukasyon, tinanong ko yung aming BLD, Bureau of Learning Development, bakit nasa pen and paper pa rin tayo sa exams? Bakit nasa paper, hard copies pa rin tayo sa libro? Ilang beses na ako nakakita ng paaralan na nasunog, and common yan for mayors and governors to see, paaralan na nasunog, classroom na nasira sa earthquake, classroom na nabaha, classroom na nasira sa bagyo, at lahat ng nasa loob noong classroom ay sira din, kasama ang mga libro. So sabi ko, bakit kayo nandyan pa rin sa papel na pwede nyo namang gawing electronic books, digital books? Yan. And so, we started to create the Department of Education Digital Education 2028. It envisioned a completely paperless mode. Hindi ko naman sinabi alisin talaga natin lahat ng papel at ballpen at lapis. But we needed to have another path that is resilient against challenges to basic education. Sabi ko sa kanila, tinanong ko, ano? Sabi nila, 1:1 tayo sa tablet, sa laptop. Sabi ko, alam nyo, yung 1:1 na yan, kahapon pa yan, nung nakaraan pa yan, 10 years ago, ang 1:1 na tablet. Sabi ko, hindi pwede yan. Kasi gagastos ka lang ng gagastos, ibibenta lang yan, laptop mo, nanakawin lang yung laptop mo, sira lang yung laptop mo. Sabi ko sa kanila, ilagay mo yan sa cloud. Ilagay mo yan where the student, anywhere and everywhere, can access the materials, the resource materials, the books. Sabi ko, hindi naman lahat. Sabi nila, hindi naman lahat may cellphone. Totoo yan, hindi lahat may cellphone. Pero marami ang may PisoNet. Sabi ko, kung saan man yan sila, makukuha pa rin yan nila pababa, galing sa cloud, doon sa PisoNet. Sabi nila, paano yung mga, sabi ko sa inyo, di ba, kalaban ng innovation, tao din. Paano yung mga nasa paaralan na walang kuryente? Sabi ko, di ba, ang dami-daming nag-offer sa atin ng mga solar panels? Sabi ko, bakit hindi natin gamitin yon to power the cloud? To power the Starlink? It is an uphill battle to present innovation to people. Kaya, pagdating sa innovation, ibenta mo muna yung idea . Ganun ang ginawa, di ba, ni Apple, Steve Jobs, ganun ang ginawa niya, di ba? Binenta muna niya ang, was it iPad first, no? Una-una ang iPhone. Nauna ang iPad, I think. Binenta niya muna ang iPad bago niya sinabihan ng mga tao, look, pwede yan sa iPhone. Or is it the other way around? Basta merong nauna. Because he had to present it first sa mga tao. Na it can be done. So, you still need to do marketing sa innovation, sa idea, before you sell your innovative product. But we can get there. And we will get there. We just have to move faster than the way we are moving right now as a country. Inclusivity remains an essential signifier of meaningful growth and development. It is expected that we embrace new and emerging opportunities, cognizant of our special contract to be inclusive. Despite the peculiarities of the present and future global business trends, innovative technologies such as robotics, drones, and artificial intelligence are all created to increase efficiency and enhance the outcome and quality of work across industries. We shall march on the beat of these new global trends through our workers' strength, energy, and hearts. It may just give a comment about peace and order. Peace and order na yan, na lagi sinasabi, ay, kulang kasi ang police natin. Kasi with AI, with robotics, with everything in digital form, we don't need more humans to become policemen. We only need to harness what is available right now to improve our security, to improve our peace and order. So again, I go back. Ang challenge ng innovation ay tao din. We shall march on the beat of these new global trends through our workers' strength, energy, and hearts. And these make humans dependable, reliable, and powerful machines. Mga kababayan, ang lahat ng ating ginagawa ay para sa Diyos, sa bayan, at sa bawat pamilyang Pilipino. Shukran.